Today I will talk about APIs, and I'm sure if you are working in IT industry, if you're a programmer, or if you work on, let us say, some tools, I'm sure you are familiar with this term. So API is nothing but application programmable interface or application programming interface. But I want to talk about what exactly is an API and why do we need this API thing, and what is the need of having these APIs in your application. So I want to give you this explanation, a simple explanation, by taking one example of a simple code that you're writing. So let us say you are learning programming, or if you are creating some project for your college. So let us say you're working on a calculator application. So in a typical calculation, in a typical calculator, you have a few things like addition, subtraction, multiplication or division. So let us say you build this great app or great application where you have a few functions. Let us say we are just focusing on addition, subtraction, maybe division, and then of course your multiplication. So it's a very simple calculator, and in this calculator you have four different functions. And when you talk about these functionalities, you also have some code, you also have some logic behind it. So you have a code, and to interact with your application you also have this great user interface. So in this user interface, it could be, let us say, a way using web interface, it could be on a console, or it could be maybe on let us say a mobile app. You can also build a mobile app for this. And there are a couple of other interfaces, like you can also make some kind of a native application for Windows or Mac. So I'm sure you are familiar with the calculator app on your desktop or laptop, and you need to install them. So there are a couple of UIs that you can build. So for this particular calculator application or software that you have just built, you also want other people to interact with it. For example, let us say in the beginning you launched this particular calculator on the web. Let us say you created a website called as amazingcalculatorbyravi.com, and when you create this website, of course people will come to your website and they will use the web interface to interact with your calculator to do some amazing calculations. However, what if I also want to use your calculator, like the other person or the other services, but they don't want to use your UI? So the concept of API is to create one interface between your application and your external world. So for example, in a typical software, or let us say in this particular calculator, you have, let us say, some input and you also have the output. Now, if I am using the UI that you created, like the web interface, I will be simply using this particular URL that I will open, amazingcalculatorbyravi.com, and I will use the UI. And the input in this case is maybe a number, and based on the function or based on the calculation that I want to perform, I'll get some output. Now, the thing is that if you want to expose these functionalities, these four functionalities which we are talking about here, to your external services, maybe you want to open up the access of your application, the logic, without using the UI that you created. So with the help of this application programming interface, what I can do, I can expose some of these functions to the external world. So let us say I want to expose my addition and maybe my division. And what will happen now, with the help of the APIs that I will be creating, other services or other websites can provide the input using this API, and they will probably interact with my application by sending some data, and that data would be, let us say, some XML file. And this XML file will contain the calculations that you want to perform, let us say the number and the function or the functionality that you want to do, and the application will then give you the output and return it back. So this input and output is done, the interaction is happening using the application, this application programming interface layer, and it is only exposing certain functionality, not really all of it. And the good thing of API is that you can, of course, expose some of the functionality, and it is also safe because with the help of this layer, you are only exposing the elements of your application that you want to expose. And also the good thing is that the other services or the external third-party services, they can just use the logic and they can have their own interface, they can have their own UI. So, for example, the best example that I'll probably give you is, let us say, Facebook. So we all use Facebook using Facebook.com, and it is the official website. We also have the official Facebook app, mobile app, on different platforms. However, you also have the capability of interacting with Facebook using the APIs that they provide. So with the help of those APIs, you can do a lot of things. For example, you can create your own games, and you can also use Facebook for authentication. And one of the best example apart from Facebook is travel flight booking. And you know that we have different sites like Make My Trip, we have booking.com, we have Expedia. So when you go to these websites, they will do the booking for you, and they will do the booking on different flight services, and they are actually using the APIs of other providers. And with the help of these APIs, you can extend and you can also enable the interaction of your application using programming in any language. And it is one of the most common way to expose your services. And if you are thinking of, let us say, launching your new service or a product in the market, you will of course start with your website. You will also have your mobile applications. But if you think in future people will be using your application and maybe you want to charge them for using it, or maybe you want to give them the functionality to interact with your service or to interact with your product programmatically, so they are not bound by the UI that you provide. So I hope in this video I was able to explain in a simple language what exactly is API. And I highly recommend you to go to the Wikipedia page and to you know, spend some time understanding the definition and what all you can do with API. And if you are a programmer, if you are learning to code, there will be a point in your career where you will be using the APIs for sure. And I'm sure you must have come across this term called REST, which is like a standard when it comes to APIs. So I'll probably create more videos where I will be talking about, of course, the REST API, and it is one of the most commonly used API in today's market. So I hope this video was useful. Thank you very much.